चैप्टर नंबर 7 कंट्रोल एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन। इन कंट्रोल एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन वी ऑलरेडी नो अबाउट टू टाइप ऑफ सिस्टम्स, नर्वस सिस्टम एंड एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम। फर्स्ट वी स्टडी ऑल अबाउट नर्वस सिस्टम इन एनिमल। नर्वस सिस्टम एंड एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम आर वेल डेवलप, ऑल्सो वेल डेवलप इन ह्यूमन, बट इन प्लांट्स एज वी नो only endocrine system can be developed. Now we go through animals and first we get the knowledge all about nervous system and then study endocrine system. To study nervous system, first we draw the structure of neuron. Neuron is the structural and functional unit of nervous system. The structure of neuron can consist dendrite, cell body. In cell body, nucleus can be present. Here, some node-like structure can be present. It is called Ranvier's node. Scientists who find the node-like structure which is Ranvier, so we called it Ranvier's node. You draw the node-like structure instead of upper side or lower side, not both sides. Along with dendrite, we draw the axon, we draw long nerve, it is called axon, and end of the axon we draw nerve endings. This is the structure of neuron. First we try to understood about with the structure of neuron how nerve impulses travel in the body. This figure shows the pathway of nerve impulses. Nerve impulses can get through dendrite, then cell body. In the cell body, they pass through axon and pass through the nerve ending. This is the pathway of nerve impulses travel in the cell body. Let's write it. Nerve fibers, neuron, and dendrites, we write here. And dendrites make the structure of nerve impulses. First, impulses are getting by dendrites. Then nerve impulses go through cell body. Here one thing notice it that the short structure, short branches are called dendrite and long branches called axon. Here we can draw only 4 to 5 cells, not too much of cells are needed in the structure of axon. Let's go it. First, nerve impulses are getting by dendrites. They pass through cell body, and cell body they pass through axon, and with the help of axon they pass through nerve endings. When the impulses pass from now endings some chemicals can also release by the impulses with the impulses and they pass the information through the second neuron. Let's try to understand. In our body is made up of many cells, multicellular body, and in all cells they take information. So in body, information passes through one cell to another with the help of neuron. In our body, many neurons can be present. Here we see one simple structure, one structure of neuron. In body, many neurons can be present. First dendrite, cell body, axon, nerve endings, then second dendrites, axon, ending of nerve impulses, then second, third, fourth, fifth. Many neurons can be structurally present in the body for the getting information and give the response. In first, dendrites get the information and go through, information passes through cell body, cell body through axon and nerve endings. In with nerve endings, they can be secrete some chemicals. Then information pass through another neuron's dendrites. Got it? And same process will be happen. Dendrites through cell body, axon, nerve endings. Then information pass through another neuron's dendrites. And dendrites getting cell body. And this structure shows when passed through the information. Many neurons can be present to getting the information, pass information from one organ to another organ. And during two neurons, between two neurons, one small, slightly small space or gap will be present to ending of first neuron and starting of second dendrites. Slightly gap, slightly space will be present and it is called synapse. One more important question, let's write it. So here we write nerve endings secrete some chemicals and get the information from second neurons of dendrites. Between two neurons, slightly gap will be present. It is called synapse. With the help of synapse, and then information pass through second neuron. Many neurons can be present in body to pass the information first. Dendrites can take the information, getting the information. Impulses and information are gets by dendrites. Then information pass through cell body and with the help of axon. They can be passed through nerve endings. In nerve endings, they secrete some chemicals and get the information for second dendrites, as we seen in slightly small figures. Then pass through another neurons. In chain of neurons can be present in our body, so organs get information quickly. Here, textual exercise question number 5 is complete. Draw the structure of neuron and how nerve impulses travel in the body. Let's go through another point. It is called reflex action. As we know, many receptors can be present in our nose, ear, hands, skin. Many receptors can be present. They can receive the impulses from outer environment and give the action for it, hot, cold, touch. And they get stimuli and give the response for it. It is called reflex action. Reflex action is an involuntary response to external stimuli without the knowledge of voluntary centers of brain. As we know, two words, involuntary and voluntary. The activity can be present in voluntary natures are called voluntaries, are may controlled by voluntary centers, and involuntary they can be made automatically. It is called metabolic processes. It is called involuntary response. Is an involuntary response to external stimuli without the knowledge of voluntary centers of brain is called reflex action. Let's see the examples of reflex action. First, notice here, the reflex action can be occurred only by spinal cord. Brain cannot be participate in the reflex action. So in our central nervous system can be present in center. A central nervous system made by two organs, it is called brain and spinal cord. The action will be occurred by the spinal cords are called reflex action. Brain cannot be involved in the reflex action, but they can get the information after the action can be completed. Let's see the examples of reflex action. When we withdraw our hand or leg when it touch with hot vessel or sharp things, we withdraw our hand or leg quickly. Coughing, sneezing, yawning, action of diaphragm, knee jerk, when light can be present, focus in our eyes, we slightly small our pupils. It is called reflex action. some watering fluid can be present when we see our when we see or when we sight or smell delicious food. The watery substances, watery fluid can be present in our mouth. Reflex action. What is the reflex action? Give examples of it. Important question for tumors. And let's see how the reflex action can occur and the path of reflex action. It is called reflex arc. Here we draw the figure for reflex arc. This is the spinal cord which is connected by CNS and then message go through brain. After action will be completed, then brain message go to brain, the action will be complete. Here we draw the figure, here we draw hand this side, you have to draw hand in left side, but when you have to care for this, the reflex neuron, relay neuron can be draw in the left side. When we draw the hand, we mention the relay neuron with the hand sides. The figure will be already right, completed. But you draw hand in left side, you draw the relay neuron this side. Spinal cord, relay neuron, CNS, central nervous system. You in exam, one word question, one marks question will be occur. Write the full form of CNS, central nervous system. Central nervous system are connected with two parts, brain and spinal cord. The action will be completed by spinal cord. It is called reflex action, and the path we shows the reflex action, it is called reflex arc. Let's see. First, in reflex arc, involvement of motor neuron and sensory neuron with spinal cord, it is called reflex arc. Two neurons can be connect with the in the reflex arc. It is called motor neuron and sensory neuron. First, we take the example of when we touch our hand with hot vessel, hand will be quickly withdrawn when our hand touch hot vessels, the hand is quickly withdrawn. Let's write first example. Example, there are many example for reflex action. We see some examples. Let's take one. First of all, sensory neuron get the impulses, get the stimuli in the form of stimuli. Through sensory neuron, impulses can pass through spinal cord and spinal cord give the information to motor neurons, and motor neuron receptors can be present here. The receptor is skin, and action of that hand will withdraw. Let's see. First, stimuli can be getting by the sensory neurons. Here the sensory neurons in the form of stimuli touch the hot vessel. The sensory neurons give the impulses, they go through impulses, they pass the impulses from spinal cord. Spinal cord pass the impulses to motor neurons. Motor neurons means movable neurons, and it goes through information here. The muscles will be present in human, in animal and human. The muscles have structure with the protein, characteristic of protein, so they can be movable, it shorter longer. So the motor neuron can be activate and the hand will be withdrawn. This whole path like is a arc. Sensory neuron, spinal cord, and then motor neurons and withdrawal. This whole path is like a arc, so it is called a reflex arc. Write short note on reflex action, or write short note on spiral reflex. Reflex arc can be present by the spinal reflex, spinal cord. Here one most important question is here, it is related also textbook question number 5. Draw the structure of neuron and how now impulses travel in the body. What is reflex action, and give its examples, and draw the diagram. First of all, you spinal reflex, and then explain it. The question is, write short note on reflex arc will be connected by, will be happen by spinal reflex.